Vasari Veneziano is a natural plaster made with finely powdered marble limestone. Veneziano has been used throughout the centuries in the world's finest architecture. It complements both traditional and contemporary settings. Veneziano can be used on large-scale projects and accent areas. It can be applied over latex paint, standard drywall primer, and cementitious surfaces. Veneziano can be applied on some exteriors and even inside shower stalls. Applied usually in two coats, Veneziano can have subtle color variation and a satin-like finish. Or it can also be polished to a high marble-like sheen. Veneziano is a tintable plaster with an option of thousands of colors. Color combinations and creative styles are unlimited. For new construction, we typically recommend at least a level 3 or 4 drywall taping finish. You can smooth out previously textured walls with gypsum plaster too, but don't forget, you'll need extensive sanding and one coat of primer afterwards, so 3 coats of plaster is typically more efficient. Any trim or cabinets around the walls should ideally be stained, varnished, lacquered, or finished already. A perfect masking job can make all the difference between an amateur job and a professional finish. When masking, you have a wide option of tools, such as a masking machine with paper or masking tape with plastic. Use plastic or paper to cover windows, floors, and countertops. Basically, you're masking as you would for a paint job. You can leave a slight reveal of the adjacent substrate exposed if you plan on a thicker application of the plaster. Before getting into it, safety first. As with any plaster, wear latex gloves and safety glasses. Be extra careful not to get any plaster in your eyes. You'll need a trowel, a hawk, and something to get the plaster from the pail to the hawk. There are 8, 12, or 16-inch trowels. Pick whichever best suits your needs and whichever is most comfortable for you. You can use most trowels available in hardware stores. Make sure your trowel has a very straight edge. You can grind down the corners, eliminating any potential lines. You can also use a pool trowel. The most difficult part of application for most people seems to be getting the plaster from the hawk onto the trowel. Just cream the plaster from the top. Don't scrape it off. The more you agitate the plaster from the hawk, the thinner the consistency will be and the more difficult to work with. Deeper colors will often be thinner in consistency. The first coat should be applied about 1/16th to 1/32nd of an inch. Don't scrape on the first coat, but apply it with a creamy smoothness. If you want a smooth, polished finish, apply the plaster as smooth as possible. If you want an unpolished, slightly textured finish, you can give it some texture. Make sure you don't have any unnatural trowel marks on your first coat. For the smoother finish, you can compress the first coat after it starts to dry to knock down any heavier areas. You can also apply 3 coats, only burnishing the last coat for a perfect polish. Again, there are 2 basic ways to apply Veneziano. The first is to burnish it, that is to polish it and bring out more depth and sheen, and the second way is to leave it relatively unburnished, without much sheen, and with only subtle color variation and modeling. With these 2 methods, you can achieve unlimited possibilities. Allow at least 24 hours to completely dry. For the polished or burnished version of Veneziano, lightly sand the wall with a fine sanding sponge to make sure you don't have any undesired bits of texture left on the first coat. Wipe off any remaining dust. Work from top to bottom of the wall. With a small amount of plaster on your trowel, apply a very thin layer to an area. It should be so thin that it begins to dry within seconds. As this happens, apply another thin layer in the same area. The second layer will dry slower. Now, with the edge of your clean trowel, apply pressure and polish out the plaster at a 5 to 20 degree angle. You'll see instant results as a nice polish starts to take place. To get a sharp line where the plaster meets other substrates, run your finger with plaster along the tape before or during your second coat. Don't make a ridge of texture while doing this. Watch your corners. Gently go around corners and bullnoses. Sometimes you might have to use your hands. You can burnish the same area 5 or more times if needed. Each pass will make the plaster more reflective and deeper in color. You'll see how different pressure and angles can give you different qualities. Don't burnish when it's still too wet, or it might crackle or tear when dried. You can apply up to 10 thin layers in the same manner. Each layer should set up a little bit before applying the next. As you have more layers, you'll have more open time to burnish the plaster. The more layers you have, the more variated and mottled the plaster will be. The smaller the trowel you use, the busier it will be still. You can use a larger trowel like a 16-inch for larger areas. Ultimately, use the trowel which is comfortable and efficient on the project. Use different tools for smaller areas or tight spots. As the plaster dries, it will have a beautiful polish with deep variations of light and dark tones, depending on where you burnished it and how much. At this point, you can call it finished and remove the masking, or you can polish it more with a super fine steel wool for more sheen and color depth. You can also wax it with a natural beeswax or waterproof it by sealing it with a plaster sealer. You can combine endless colors of plaster for more effect. Here's a burnished four-color Veneziano, followed by a light brown wax. For the unburnished or unpolished version, you can leave more texture on the first coat. Apply a thicker first coat if plastering over previous texture. Here we have a dried first coat with a small amount of texture. We'll use a 16-inch trowel. Here we're not scraping it on, but troweling slightly thicker coats. Allow each layer to set up a little before applying more. After several minutes, you can lightly burnish the wall once or twice. You're not going for a polish necessarily, just a subtle, silky variation. Let the plaster dry completely. It'll dry much lighter than when wet. At this point, you can leave it alone, or you can sand it with a fine, beveled, worn sanding sponge or something similar. By lightly sanding it, you're polishing and compacting it and bringing out the color from the areas you lightly burnished. With a light sanding sponge or similar, you can also straighten out corners and bull noses. You can even wet the plaster and gently sand out other imperfections. And finally, when you're satisfied with the look, you should wipe any excess dust off the wall. You can also wax it or seal it. Unsealed or unwaxed plaster is much easier to repair or change. Unburnished Veneziano is a very fast and easy application which works fantastically on both small and large spaces. With these simple methods, you can achieve a truly endless variety of Veneziano plaster. Just remember, make a few sample boards before committing to the real thing. We promise that within minutes, you'll understand plastering with Vasari Veneziano Plaster. For ordering products, checking out the latest application tips, and much more, visit us at VasariPlaster.com. Enjoy the rest of our complimentary video series on creating the best wall finishes in the world.